Hello everyone, welcome back in biology class. Today we will start a new topic in this chapter, that is mitochondria. Mitochondria is very small rod shaped organelle and very important for cellular respiration to release energy that is required to carry on different energy requiring activities of the cell. This mitochondria is visible under light microscope, but its detailed structure can be revealed only by using electron microscope. It is first of all discovered by A.V. Albert von Kolliker in 1857. That is mitochondria named. Again, it was named bioblast by Richard Altman in 1886, and after 12 years, it again named by the mitochondria. It discovered by Albert von Kolliker in 1857. Okay, now where it occur? Occurrence of mitochondria. This mitochondria occur in all aerobic eukaryotic cells. It is altogether absent in anaerobic protozoans prokaryotes and mature mammalian RBCs. Okay, it is absent in this type of cells. Now let's talk about the structure of mitochondria. Mitochondria can be mostly oval, but it can be spherical, cylindrical. Mitochondria is sausage shaped usually, but it can be oval, cylindrical, filamentous or even branched. It is enclosed in a bilayer membrane. The outer membrane is freely permeable for middle size, smaller size molecules as well as ions, while the inner membrane throws out in different folds. And these folds are called cristae. In this way, you are seeing here. And this cristae has many small ATP generating assemblies, and these ATP generating assemblies throughout the cristae, you can draw in this way, are called oxysomes. These are called oxysomes. In this way. The space between outer membrane and inner membrane. This is inner membrane. Inner membrane and space between outer membrane and inner membrane, this space is called outer chamber. Outer chamber. This filled with a clear homogeneous fluid, and these folds are called crista. Crista, that is the singular. Singular, and cristae is the plural. Okay. Likewise, mitochondria is a plural number and mitochondrion is singular number. And this is filled with matrix that has the ribosomes, ions, proteins, lipids and a circular DNA. This matrix having a circular DNA. Circular DNA, ribosomes are there distributed in mitochondrial matrix. These are ribosomes. Ribosomes. Okay. And this you can say mitochondrial matrix. This matrix contains enzymes, lipids, RNA, ribosomes, circular DNA and ions are present in mitochondrial matrix. Enzymes are respiratory enzymes. Okay, so this is how mitochondria looks under the electron microscope. This assembly, these are called oxysomes. Okay, so this is the diagram how mitochondria looks. Now about the function, most of you are knowing that mitochondria is responsible to produce energy by the process of respiration. Okay? Yes, it is function. Mitochondria use molecular oxygen. It is the main seat of respiration, and mitochondria use the molecular oxygen. Molecular oxygen to stepwise breakdown of respiratory substrate like carbohydrate, fat. These are stepwise breakdown inside mitochondria in presence of molecular oxygen to release energy and form water and carbon dioxide. You can take here C6H12O6. This is carbohydrate and named glucose. In presence of oxygen plus O2, what happens? This breakdown into carbon dioxide plus water and energy released. Okay, energy released. So this is this process looking simple, but it is stepwise, a complex process happens inside the mitochondria. This energy temporarily stored in the form of ATP. ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine triphosphate. Okay. In temporarily stored in adenosine triphosphate and transported in the cells or in different cells for various energy requiring activities. So the mitochondria is called powerhouse or storage batteries, and this ATP called energy currency of the cell. Okay, energy currency of the cell. One more thing I want to mention here about the feature of mitochondria, that it has DNA, its own DNA. So mitochondria is able to synthesize some of its protein itself. Mitochondria, as just I written here, that mitochondrial matrix contain respiratory enzymes, lipids, RNA, ribosomes, circular DNA and ions. So this circular DNA has the code of proteins, different types of proteins that are present in the mitochondria. So mitochondria is able to synthesize some of its protein itself. That's why it is also named as semi-autonomous organelle. Semi-autonomous organelle of the cell. Okay. So this is all about the mitochondria today. Hope you will able to understand. Okay. Till then, watch the video again and again. Thank you very much. Have a nice day to all of you.